Are we recording?
Yes, we are. G'day, Bill. And welcome to sunny Dunedin, where it's about 4 degrees outside and we had snow showers last night. Can't wait to get over to Brisbane in a month's time. We're staying there for a month, so we're going to lose a bit of our winter over there. Anyway, I've got the LX100 mounted on the cranium and stuff. So I'll take it off and show you how to invert it, hopefully. So that's it off, and now what I do is go like that, and now it's inverted. As you can probably see, I'm holding the camera because the lens isn't out, but that's the position you want it in for inverted, as you no doubt agree. And then to get it back, hope you can see this, I simply do that. So it's hard to explain, but you can't do it that way, and you can't do it that way. Okay, once again, it's inverted here, and to invert, to get it right again, you bring it around that way, and now it's right. So that's the right way around, and that is inverted. I hope that's I hope you figured out how to do it from that, but it can be done. I've actually mounted the hang on, I'll bring it around again. So, and I'll fire up the camera. So now that it's, I'll put it back on the tripod. And the camera's on, so it's I'm sure yours is be the same, it's all balanced up properly. And then I'll fire it up. And then I use the, what mode do I use? It's pan and following mode. So if I click on the, start it up and then click on the mode button twice, I get that a wee dip in the camera, and then you can sort of pan following mode lets you drop it down, and that's how I use it. I find that works best, because when you point it down it goes down, when you point it up it goes up, and when you pan it around it slowly comes around and follows you, and that seems to work quite good for me. Yeah, we're on a bit of an angle, but that's alright. But you can't do that when the camera's going. You can't invert it when the camera's going. So, like I say, you have to turn, what I do is always turn the stabilizer off first. If you turn the camera off first, as you probably figured out, the lens will come in, the gimbal will become unbalanced and it'll start shaking. So I always turn the gimbal off first, and then turn the camera off, and then just take it off, hold it. I'll see if I can do it quickly this time, and turn it around like that, and then you're ready. You're ready to turn it back on, and she's balanced. You know, she's what do you call it? Inverted. What's the other thing I've got? I'll show you. I made up a knob for it. I didn't want it to slip out of my hands. This is when before I got the other Scotty's gimbal, Scotty stabilizer. I made up a knob, and that just comes off. That the release plate comes off, and that screws in, and then I could just hold it, and I had that wrapped around my hand, so I couldn't drop it. That screwed into the hole at the bottom, and I was able to actually hang on to the whole thing with just that knob, which is really good because you could hang on to it rather loosely, and it helps stabilize it even more. Just something to throw at you there. So now that it's inverted, I'll turn the crane arm back on again. And two clicks on the mode button will give me my right setting, and then she's good to go. It'll pan down or come up if I wanted to. And of course it'll pan around. So in reversing that, I would need to stop the turn off the cranium first, and then the camera, and then the lens can come back in, and I can bring it back right to the upright position again, then turn the camera on, then turn the stabilizer on, the cranium on. And it's back to the way it was. Yep, hope that helps anyway, Bill. This is my current setup and the way I like to do my videoing now when I'm on the walk, when I'm walking. Scotty's stabilizer, and I've mounted the cranium vertically on that. And I've also got a cell phone here that I can I Bluetooth over from the camera, so I can do touch focus on that. So it works quite good. Looks a bit cumbersome, but it's quite light, and it's you can see what you're videoing. That's the bit I like. You can see in the, I don't know if you can see in there. No, you probably can't. Don't know how to do this, I'm not very good at this, but if I hold it that way, you will. You can see what the camera's looking at in there. And quite a few camera functions on the cell phone. It's connected by the Panasonic app. The Panasonic app, yeah. So, but this stabilizer works. And helps with the bobbing that you get when you're walking. This is what I like. And it's also good to hang on to. It's quite light. The whole thing was made on a printer, believe it or not. You'd probably know about that, but I don't. but you can see how it's in the pan and tilt following mode. This is where if I tip it up, it will look down, and when I tip it back, it will look up. So you can bring it right up like that if you want, and yeah, very good, and it'll just slowly pan around. So that's the latest thing that I use, and quite good. Right, I'll whack it back on there. These quick release plates certainly do the job.